Hi, grades three. Today we are looking at our lesson nine. It is review four. So you do not need your textbook for this, but you do need your workbook. And you will open your workbooks to page 107. And it is this. So it's the review. Okay. So you have to finish page 107 all the way to page 110. It is 1, 2, 3. It is 4 pages long. Okay, so let's get started and I'll do some questions with you. The ones that are a bit challenging or that may be a bit challenging. And then you'll go ahead and finish the rest of the review on your own, okay? So on this first page, what you have to do is, they've given you these in words. You have to write them in numbers. So for example, the first one is 5,306. So how would you write 5,306? So you need to ask yourself, how many thousands do I have? Well, I have five, right? So you have 5,000. So I'll show you. So it says 5,306. So I have 5,300. I don't have any tens. Six, right? So that's what you need to do. On the first one, you need to write, they've given you in words, you need to write them in numbers, okay? So you're gonna read the numbers, 5,306. The next one is 8,005. And you need to ask yourself, if you need help drawing the place value chart, feel free to do that. Do you remember how you do it? So let's take this number, right? And we have our ones place, our tens place, our hundreds, and our thousand. So ones, read the number. So have they given you thousands? Write the thousands. Have they given you any hundred? Write the hundreds. Have they given you any tens? Write the tens. Have they given you any ones? Write the ones. If they have not given you tens, write a zero. If they're not given you hundreds, write a zero. So whatever numbers they've given you, go ahead and start. So if you need help, as in if you are a bit confused about how, where, which number goes, just draw your place value chart. And so ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands. Okay, you can draw that to help you finish this question. However, if you know it without having to draw your place value chart, then go ahead and do it, okay? So that's what you need to do for your first question. Then they've given you, they've said, write the missing numbers in the following number pattern, right? So they've given you 4,120, 4,220. My next would be 4,320 because the next one is 4,420. So I've just given you, this would be 4,320 because our hundreds are jumping, right? 100, so look at the hundreds place. 100, 200, this would be 3 because this is 4. So always look for the pattern. Are my thousands changing? Are my hundreds changing? Are my tens changing? Or are my ones changing? That's what you need to look at to find the pattern. So these are the questions. Then our third one is fill in each blank with the word greater or less. Okay, so you need to ask yourself, is this number greater or less than this number? For example, let's look at the first one. 3,459 is blank than 3,495. So let's look at both numbers. This is 3,459. This is 3,495. Which number is greater? This number, right? Because it is 3,495. This number is smaller than this number. So what am I going to write in this blank? I'm going to say 3,459 is less than 3,495 because it's less. Okay, so all you need to do is you need to read both of these numbers and see, is it going to be less or is it going to be greater? So that's how you would do these questions. Then we go at the bottom, find the missing numbers. So over here at the bottom we have, so they've given us, basically they've broken down the numbers for us. So they've said 3,000, What do you need to add to make this number equal to 3,800? So what's the missing number? They've given you 3,000. What do you need to add? 800, because that's what the missing, so where it says equal, that's what they're asking you to make, okay? So they're asking you, how would you make, we have given you these numbers, how would you make these numbers? So you look at your place value again, or you read the number and you ask yourself, well, which number is the missing one? So the first one, the answer is, they've given you 3,000, they're saying, how would you make 3,800? So we would add 800 to this 3,000 and it would become this number. Does that make sense? Then let's go ahead and let's look at our next page. So on our next page, it is subtracting. That's, we know how to do that one. 2,000 take away 850. Remember to stack your numbers. Then even if they've done it vertically, remember to stack your numbers so you can do it horizontal, or sorry, they have done it horizontally, you can do it vertically. So like this, right? So we stack our numbers. Then it's adding again, they've given you horizontally. So 950 plus 50, you can write your numbers vertically, right? Then they have given you multiplication, they've given you horizontally, okay? So I'm gonna do one division and one multiplication with you, just so that we get a bit of a refresher on how to do multiplication and division. So they've given you multiplication and they've said 523 times 7. I do not know that from the top of my head, right? And especially it's horizontal. So I need to stack my numbers vertically to help me solve this one, okay? Then they've given you 720 divided by 7. Remember, this week is 7 times table. So we should have been reviewing our 7 times table. Then it is 400 divided by 2, and then 700 times 2. So from these questions, grades 3, I am going to do C and D. One is multiplication and one is division, so that we get a quick review on how to multiply and how to divide. So let's get started before we move on. So here I've written down these questions for us. So I am doing C. So number 5, so page 108 in your workbook, I'm looking at C. Okay, so 523, they've done it this way. What I did was I stacked my numbers. So I'm gonna do it vertically to make it easier for me to multiply. So for this one, I have to know, if you need to use your times table sheets, you can feel free to take those out, because we should have been practicing these the whole week, right? So let's go ahead and remember, I need to multiply the 7 to my 1s, and 7 to my 10s, and 7 to my 100s. So let's get started. 7 times 3 gives me 21. I write my 1 here, I take my 2 at the top. 7 times 2 gives me 14. Plus 2, so 15 and 16. I write my 6, I take my 1 at the top. Then I do 7 times 5 gives me 35 plus 1. 36. So that's what you get when you multiply your 523 to 7. We get 3,661. Okay, so that was question C. How do we multiply vertically? And this was just to give you a review. So you get to multiply 700 times 2 on your own. Okay, now let's divide. So I'm going to do D. This was C. Let's do D. Now D is long division. Okay, so let's ask ourselves, 720 divided by 7. How many 7s do I need to make this 7? I need only 1 7. So I write my whole number 1 at the top. Then I go ahead and multiply these two numbers to get an answer here, right? 7 times 1 gives me 7. Then I go ahead and subtract. I'm left with 0. Now I can bring this number down. Two is not big enough for me to divide it by seven, right? Because seven is big, two is small. So I bring this number down, and because I can't do anything with it since it's too small, I'm going to write a zero at the top. Then I go ahead and bring my zero down. Now it's big enough for me to divide it by seven, because now it's become 20 instead of two. So I go ahead and I say my seven times table. Seven times one gives me seven. Seven times two gives me 14. Seven times three gives me 21. That's too big. I do not need a 21. I need something less than 20 or 20. And something that is less than 20 in seven times table is 14. How many sevens give me 14? Two sevens, right? Seven times two. So I write my whole number two, because that's the number of sevens I'm using. Then I go ahead and multiply this two to my seven. So two times seven gives me 14. Then I subtract. I borrow. This is one. 10 take away four is six. And I am left with nothing here. So my remainder is six, and my quotient is 102. Okay, I hope this was helpful. And let's keep on going with our review. So then our next question is, Mingfa bought 420 red apples and 180 green apples. Okay, so they've given you a picture, red apples, 420, green apples, 180, right? So they're asking us, he sold 300 red apples and 100 green apples. Now you have to look at this picture. So they've given you the information. He sold 300 red apples and 100 green apples. He had 420 red, 180 green. Then you have to fill these blanks. Mingfa bought blank apples altogether. So altogether, how many did he buy? Green and red. So you have to combine those together. Then we go ahead and so you write down the number. How many did he? So that means you need to add both red and green apples numbers. Then we look at B. He sold blank apples all together. That is this information. He sold 300 red and 100 green apples. So how many did he sell all together, right? First question was, how many did he have all together? Then second one is, how many did he sell all together? Then third one is, there were blank apples left. How many apples were left? One. So what do you need to do? You need to subtract in this one. So the first two questions, you're adding something. Last one, you're subtracting something. Okay. Then on the next page, we have word problems, right? So we have these three word problems and two on the next page. Okay. So let's go ahead and we are going to do the last two. So I'm going to do the last two with you so that you would get to do these three on your own. Okay. So you're going to try these three on your own. Let's do the last two together. So here we go. So as I'm reading, I would like you to follow along. Okay. So I'm reading number 10. Pablo earns 3,000 a month. He spends 2,200 a month and saves the rest. How much money can he save in 6 months? Now this is a two-part problem, okay? We have two steps that we need to do. So the first step would be, well, we need to find out first of all, how much is he making or altogether, right? Pablo earns 3,000 a month. He spends, we need to find out, well, how much is he saving in 1 month? For us to find out, well, how much would he be saving in 6 months, right? Because we know he earns 3,000 a month. He spends 2,200 a month and saves the rest. Well, how much is he saving? Okay, so let's find that out first. So Pablo earns 3,000 a month and he spends 2,200 a month. So he is earning 3,000 a month, right? And then he is spending, so we take that away, 2,200, right? So he's spending this much. He's earning this much. He's spending this much. So this is going to tell us, well, how much is he saving each month? So let's subtract 0, 0. I borrow, this becomes 8, since this was 2 here, I'm left with 800. So that means how much is he saving in 1 month? So he's earning 3,000, he's spending 2,200, he's saving 800. If he's saving 800 in 1 month, how much would he save in 6 months? Would it be more or would it be less? It would be more, right? So for more, we multiply, right? So we have 800 and they're asking how much money can he save in 6 months, which means we need to multiply our 800 to 6. That would give us, if he's saving 800 in 1 month, in 6 months he would be saving, let's find out, 800 times 6. So let's pause the video if you need to. How about you give it a try since we just did a multiplication question? So pause the video and do the question on your own and then unpause it to see if you got it correct. Okay, so I hope you pause the video. Now let's get started back on our questions. So we remember we need to multiply our 6 to our 1s, our 6 to our 10s, and our 6 to our 100s. So 6 times 0 gives me 0. 6 times 0 gives me 0. 6 times 8 gives me 48. So how much is he saving in 6 months? He saves, so right here, he can save $4,800. Now we are done the question. Does that make sense? So please remember, when you're working on word problems, ask yourself, sometimes it's a two-step problem. It's not just one. So in this one, look, we subtract it. We first use subtraction, then we use multiplication. Okay, let's do one more. Okay, so let's do the one at the bottom, number 11. Miss Brown baked 600 pineapple tarts for sale. She packed them into packets of 6. She sold 45 packets. How many packets were not sold? Again, it's a two-step problem, which means we first need to find out, well, how many packets did she make altogether? She packed them into 6 packets of 6. She sold 45 packets. So we need to find out how many packets did she make altogether. So then we can find out, well, how many were not sold. Okay, so here we go. Miss Brown baked 600 pineapple tarts. So we know 600, and they're divided into how many packets? 6 packets, right? So let's go ahead. We know if the question is saying she divided them, she put them into these many packets, it will usually be division, okay? She put them into these many boxes, division. She gave them to 10 kids, division, okay? So 600 divided by 6. How many 6 do we need to make this 1 6? Only 1. Grades 3, I would encourage you to pause the video and try doing this division question on your own. Then you can unpause the video and see if you're getting it, right? So that's a bit of a challenge for yourself. Okay, so if you pause the video, remember to unpause it to check at the end whether you got it or not. Okay, so 6 times 1, because I need only 1 6 to make this 6. Then I go ahead and multiply, right? So I go ahead, 1 times 6 gives me 6. I'm left with 0, then I bring this 0 down. Can I do anything with this 0? I can't. Even though it says 0, it would I can't do anything with it. I still need to go ahead and put a 0 at the top, because watch this. If I don't, then basically we are saying there are 600 tarts. If there were 6 kids, each kid got 1. Does that make sense? No, it doesn't. So we bring this 0 down because we can't do anything with it. Remember, when we can't do anything with a number we bring down, we put a 0 at the top. Now I'm allowed to bring down this 0. Can I do anything with this 0? Nothing, because 0 divided by 0 times anything is always 0. So because I can't do anything with this 0 either, I need to put a 0 at the top. Now this makes sense, because that means there were how many packets? So she made 100 packets, right? So she made 100 packets and she sold 45. So the question says she sold 45 packets. How many packets were not sold? So what do we need to do? We need to take our 100, because that's what we just found out, that she made 100 packets and she sold 45, right? I borrow, this becomes a 9, this becomes a 10, 10 take away 5 is 5, 9 take away 4 is 5. So how many packets were not sold? 55 packets were not sold. There. So that's your review for today. And please make sure that you complete it. I did a couple of questions with you already, so it should be even more easier to finish it quickly. And I will see you next week.